Hey, happy Sunday, everybody. We're closed today here in the shop, but I came in to do some things. I thought maybe I'd give you a little walk around because we got a lot of cool new product and restocked on some things. So things are as far as the supply chain issues go, they're starting to get better with some companies anyway. And we've got a lot of good stuff here. One thing we do have a lot of now are reels, especially Daiwa reels. Just got in a bunch of Alexa 300s. Line counters, regular without the line counter. These Eliminator spinning reels right here. If you want something for bobber fishing, I think those are really good. That's kind of why I got these in here. Got the 3000 size and the 4000 size. Good line capacity, fast pickup, good solid durable reels. Not crazy expensive, $109. But a really good reel for the Northwest, I think. Then we got the BGs over here. Got the 3000, 4000 BGs. Which are really similar to the Eliminators. Just a little bit of a bearing difference. I just kind of double ordered. I was having such a hard time getting reels. I ordered both kinds, just hoping I'd get one of them, and I got both. So we got a lot of spinning reels. We've got a lot of good, you know, bait casters. Got some Tatulas and got some Lexa 100s in. I forgot to bring them in there in a truck. We just got some Lexa 100 line counters delivered this morning. Some Abu reels here, old-fashioned reels, good line counters. Those are good quality for the money. If you want an inexpensive reel, I think the Abus are definitely a way to go for an inexpensive reel. And the bank guys, I got some of these AccuDepths in here. I just put one of these on my bank rod. Or not just the bank guys, but you know, they're just good, inexpensive line counter reels. But really good if you're using the sandbag system, like I got one set up here, you know, with the kayak, long line. And speaking of that, we just got wiped out. I was restocked pretty well on these, so I've still got some sandbags, only 1 liter left. Gotta get more of those. And then also, he just brought in, only got 3 or 4 left here, of just the steelhead, but he's got steelhead leaders, cold water strong, got steelhead leaders and sockeye leaders. And I filmed a video with, I can't think of his name right now, but the guy that owns the company does a really good job with his products. But all the sockeye ones are gone. Everything, we only got 4 left. So they sold really fast, just a couple days. But we did a video with him kind of explaining the difference between them. And that's on YouTube too. So if you look below here and you see the link, then that means I remembered to put the link there. But check these things out. If you're fishing off the bank, they're all set up, ready to go. This is a 3 liter system, and it's called the steelhead system. And then the sockeye one has 2 liters, but they're castable. And especially the 2 liter one, it's not as long, but you can cast this one too. I haven't done it yet, but I have the 13-foot rod here, which I guarantee you will cast that 3 liter system. This is a spinning rod, but these can be built in a bait caster too. But I've been using one of these plunking with a spinning rod, kind of like it. I mean, I can cast all the way to St. Helens if I wanted to, but these rods that got here for that sort of thing are just awesome. We got a lot of rods in stock. Got the Salt Patrol jigging rods in now. And just a lot of different bobber rods. Oh, we even got side drifting rods in now. So just got a lot of new rods in. And the Salt Patrol 10.5-foot fiberglass downrigger rods are almost done. Those should be in here hopefully by the end of this coming week. So the rod selection is really increased, and we're pretty good stock here. Got some 9.5-foot kokanee rods, trout kokanee rods. Those are awesome. So we're doing pretty good with the rods now. And rod repair, of course, this is new. If you have broken eyes or need a tip glued on or a whole rod rebuilt, you can do that. Got a professional rod builder working with me now, Linda. She does a good job. This is one that she's just doing now. It's just this one that's finished drying. I'm turning this off. But I had Oscar put a rope handle on it. Got the fancy reel seat, big, heavy, old blank that someone brought in. They wanted built. So
real pretty inlays. See what she's done there. And right here, these haven't been epoxied yet. She's just working on wrapping them. So if you need repair or rod building, this is the place to do it. And also, if you want to do it on your own, got all the, you know, thread carriages and thread and the right tape and hand wrapping systems, power wrapping systems, all the epoxy, everything you need to build a rod, and can kind of help you get started with that too. It's fun. I used to do a lot of it. You know, these little things here, what are they called? Reed's rod wraps. Okay, this guy, he's a good guy. I haven't actually met him yet, but he was just always telling me how great his product is. You know, I was like, okay, yeah, I've heard that before. But he brought some in, and I started using them, and they are really cool. I've got them on a lot of, like, all my rods that I've been hauling around trying to do some plunking and sort of thing. When you break a rod and two-piece rod and you want to carry it in your car, these things are great. You know, because they work really well, and they're not expensive, and it's just a simple concept that works. In fact, see, here's one I put on my big bank rod right here. See how they just hold that baby together? One down there. So, I might even give you a Reed's rod wrap if you buy a rod. But yeah, but I've got them on the two-piece rods like this one to keep together. I'm just putting them on there, and they'll come with the rod. But like 360 or something, those things are actually pretty cool. Yeah, we got some kokanee nets in. We had twice as many last week, but we still have a few left. Got a couple handles left. Of course, we're getting more of these fiber, carbon fiber composite handles from Patriot Factory here. Been selling like crazy. And they're a really good deal. So, within a day or two, we're going to be restocked on all the Spro stuff. It's in the mail. It's coming. And Brad Schoenborn was here yesterday, Saturday. He brought in a bunch of wigglers he thought we needed, so that's nice. And also wobblers on the other side. Got to get restocked on beads here, but got soft beads and thirsty beads and some leaders. And we do have a few mooching rigs left, but we need to order some more. We only got the 3-aught or the 25-pound sold out on the 30-pound. But I apologize to all of you who came in last week looking for these, because I didn't know we had them, and I was telling you we didn't have any, but we do have some mooching leaders, but need more. Oh, we got good selection of line, got stocked up on all the lines. We had more killer fish. Boy, they were really selling like crazy the last couple months, but got wiped out again, especially on the smaller sizes, and you can see which ones were the most popular, that's for sure. But we still have some good ones in here. I kind of like this. That's a new one. What is this? Watermelon, met watermelon, whatever. New colors, gotta like that. And Beckman nets that go on those handles. We've got a lot of, these are the boards that go on the Pro Fillet boards right up there that mount on your boat or wherever. So I got a lot of them. And also those boxes right there, those are all full of the mats that go with them, but those ProFillet mats are just fantastic and sell a lot of them. So, got some good Yamamoto stuff here. The swim bait, you're heading down the North Jetty or whatever, got the swim bait you need. Oh, and did get some of these Dynasty King jigs from Fishfield, and those are really good quality jigs. And, well, just lots of stuff. Oh, we got the Nikko. Check out this Nikko stuff, high-end Japanese plastics. I'm gonna get some more of this, but these are really detailed. Here's a Heldramite. Never seen anything like that. And tadpoles, and just interesting little things. These leeches, kind of cool. Nikko's got a lot of really neat stuff like that. And we're having a special on buoys, 6 for $40, can't beat that. Lots of rooster tails. I'll get some few North Wild spinners here. We're gonna be getting a lot more of these. Real good quality spinners. I did get restocked on a little bit of the Oregon tackle stuff here. Get some blades, all the beads, kind of specialty stuff. But we do have a lot more spinners coming from, you know, Yakima and you know, all the basic spinners, plus some new companies like North Wild here. this stuff looks, I think this looks really good and it sells well. You know, had people coming in asking for it. I never really even heard of it. So we got some in and it just looks good. Little micro hoochies. And these guys, these sold right away. They were like pink, lighter colors, version of the little shrimps here. And they sold really fast. One guy came in about like $400 worth of this stuff, but good quality stuff. And let's see here. Oh, we got these Spro jig boxes in a while ago. We still have some left. Those are good boxes. Got jet divers. Boy, those were a hot item for a while. You know, some of you guys are using the jet divers like here in the Lewis River. Well, yeah, they work and nothing wrong with that. But don't forget about the Brad's divers here. I think, you know, just my opinion, those are a little better choice for a smaller river. But that's up to you. Oh, and I got these, the wee wigglers. Okay, so this here's a little secret. You know, some of these rivers around here, smaller rivers, is that when the coho come in, what guys want to cast off the bank for them. Well, there'll be a weed line, but these will not dive so deep, so you can fish off the bank and fish over that weed line. So that's why Brad brought these in, you know, specifically for that, for the guys around here fishing on the smaller rivers. So those are a good deal. Let's see, what else? Oh, don't forget about our net combo raffle we're doing here. You come in here and for every $20 you spend, you get a raffle ticket. So we're doing that at the end of the month. But we got a pretty good little pile of tickets in there. Appreciate everybody's support on that. And then the Bahio sunglasses. I brought these in because I wanted some high-end sunglasses in the shop. And I've been wearing this one right here for like a year or so. And I liked them, they're fine. But what was really good about them is they didn't break. They didn't get scratched up. You know, because that's always a problem with high-end glasses, is they just don't last very long. But these, I was impressed with the durability, so I went ahead and brought them in to the store. And so we've got these really nice, good quality Bahio sunglasses. So they're like, you know, they're right like Costa or Maui Jim or whatever, something like that. They're that level of brand, really good quality. We got a ton of clam guns here. Look at this, $40. Now, I was in Cabela's the other day. I stopped in my way up to Baker Lake. I forgot my fishing license, and so I was wanting to get a copy of my license. And I saw how much they were selling those things for. Not the same brand. They didn't even have rubber foam on them. But holy smokes, I need to reconsider my pricing because that is really cheap for one of those things, according to Cabela's anyway. And then we got some spin and glows in, but if according to what I've been told, we're going to have a lot more. So we'll see. I'm really trying to get more spin and glows. So, you know, cause look, this is the last pack. I had, I think 24 of these Friday they came in. That's the last pack of these black ones, the watermelon. These have been really hot. So we got one pack of those left, but hopefully more coming. And we got some spin fish. Some of the colors you want sold out right away, but we just got these Salt Patrol. I think those are kind of a hot deal. But we do have some spin fish and maglips. We've been doing some walleye fishing. Got some of these Spro Mad Eyes here that are really good quality. Oh, we got just a lot of stuff here. All the Castmasters, can't go wrong with those. These Scent Flash paddle flashers from Max, you know, they really do work well. A lot of power. I really like those, you know. And then we got the triangle flashers too. You fill them with scent. Oh, and then the sling blades. Look, we're having a sale on sling blades because I don't think I've ever had a sale on sling blades, but I have got a lot of sling blades. What happened was I stocked up on sling blades and a lot of Mac stuff for the Sacramento show the last January. Well, I didn't end up going to the show there, the IC show. And so, boy, do I have a lot of sling blades. So I'm trying to, you know, have a sale on sling blades and gonna reduce the inventory a little bit because, boy, I got a lot of sling blades. I got more in the back. But we do sell a lot of sling blades. And double D Dodgers too. Those are a good deal. Well, we got a lot of Hyper-Vis tape. We just got restocked on this. You know, if you haven't seen the Hyper-Vis tape, you gotta give this stuff a shot. It's kind of, it really does work. And there's a lot of fish being caught on it now. And the school of fish, you know, those fish are seeing all those 360 flashers, and they're seeing the same thing over and over and over again. Show them something different. And this is something different. You know, these have been around a while, and these guys use them a lot, but they really do put a lot of attraction out there. And here's a little hot tip. You can put a Dodger, I put it right on that scent chamber there, and that Dodger behind it makes it look like a fish chasing a school of fish, you know, and that works too. So you want to try to show those fish something a little different. Try one of those school of fish. And of course, all the Mac stuff, got a lot of cripplers and sling blade, I mean, cripplers and humdingers and sonic bait fish, and these are a good deal. I guarantee you put that on the water, especially out in the ocean, these big wiggle-hoochies with the bills, you're gonna get bit. On these hot wings, they've been selling really well. And you don't need to buy these and tear apart the wings or the flashlight blades. We got just the blades and packages over on the other side there. And sell a lot of those, especially right around here. It's kind of a local secret around here for coon shrimp. And so we've got a few spin doctors left and all the blue fox stuff. Oh, we just got these in not too long ago, the North Fork lures. These things, I took them down in Columbia here. I was kind of testing different rods and casting a little bit and trying to catch a sockeye or steelhead or whatever, catch down there, and I didn't catch anything, but boy, could I cast these things a long ways. I mean, just amazing how far you can cast these things, if that's important. But good looking lures. These guys have been building these for a long time around here, and they're really awesome. Got some with hoochies on them. You know, really good quality. I'm sure they're gonna get knocked off real soon though. And then halibut spreaders, need some halibut spreaders. Got a few pro trolls, we'll be stocking those up more. The wobbler floats, yeah, we've got some wobblers in. Wobbler fishing's back, a lot of people catching fish on wobblers now. Blue, you know, this time of year, as it starts progressing, you know, to late summer, blue becomes more important. So we got some nice blue ones in here. These have all, what I did is I had my buddy that I know, he does a lot of wobbler fishing, and I gave him Brad's catalog. I said, okay, well, pick out, you know, which colors you want. And so that's what he did. So these are kind of hand-picked by a local here, the ones that he wanted in particular. So got some good stuff, and then some of these too. Yeah, that one, I like that one. So anyway, and all cushets and everything, got a lot of lead. Try to stay stocked up on lead and Oregon tackle. We're gonna do some bobber fishing. We got this good weights, so we got quite a bit of lead. But we do, we got a problem there. But hopefully we'll be stocked up pretty quick. Oh, we got Oregon tackle downrigger weights. Here we go, 6, 8, and 10 pound, just round balls with the fins if you want that. People have been asking for downrigger weights, so we finally got downrigger weights in here. And of course, we have one of the best, if not the best, selection of Procure around anywhere. And it must work, because people sure buy a lot of it. You know, I tell you what, people think, oh, I don't need scent, you know, I catch plenty of fish. Well, I'm sure you do, but you know, you might catch more if you use some scent. Because I'll tell you what, I'll tell you a little story. The other day, I was filming on Baker Lake, and we went, it was a no bite. There was like nothing going on. I mean, there's 100 boats out there or whatever, and not a single net for like the first hour. I'm like, oh boy, I just, you know, this is like stressful on the poor guide and the whole thing, you know. But because it was like one of the ugliest sockeye bites I've ever seen. But that's the way it goes. Of course, the light switch can change and all of a sudden they start biting, you know. So, but we're fishing about an hour, nothing. And I had a bottle of shrimp oil here, this stuff. So I gave it to, it was with Brianna, Bruce. And I said, well, you ever try this, you know? And so she squirted on one of her baits, you know, had what, 5, 6 rods out. And boom, within a few minutes, I had a fish on that particular rod. And so she did on another rod. So I think most of the fish we caught that day actually came on the coon shrimp that was sprayed with this. I've seen that over and over and over again over the years. So, you know, I'm a believer in this, and people sure do buy a lot of it. So it must be working. But if you're steelhead fishing, right here, that's what you want, as far as I'm concerned. So I know, of course, there's a lot of others, but the shrimp krill, you know, the sockeye and stuff, I mean, you can see that's been selling really well. And it's bloody tuna always sells well, thick stuff, anchovy, you know, it's what you'd expect to be selling well has been selling well. So on this side, we've got all the powdered scents and the rooster tail scent spray, which is made by ProCare, which is really good too. And I like these bottles, you know, that, you know, like if I'm going to the coast, And I don't have, I like the bottle, right? It's just small and it fits in your pocket well, and that's good stuff. The kokanee, you know, for you doing your corn, just get this stuff for your corn, and that's gonna help you out a lot. All the cures and everything, so got a lot of ProCure stuff. So we're looking pretty good here. Oh, and the Neal's Master, these smaller Invincibles sure sold well, but we got these down here. I need to get these up higher where people can see them, but these are the UV ones. And these are some good looking baits. So we got these Neal's Masters here. If you're chasing tiger muskie or you just want a big stick bait, these Neal's Masters from Finland are awesome. All the jigs, you're going to do some rock fishing or whatever. Get your fish field jigs, not too expensive, and they work really well. And the halibut lights, those things are a must if you're halibut fishing. Another must. Oh, the assist hooks. That's all I do anymore, is one assist hook right off the top. And that's the only hook you need. That's it. I don't put anything else on them. That works great. Once you get them hooked on an assist hook, they're not going to come off. Pretty good selection of, you know, your different terminal tackle. You get the high quality Spro and the Poochie stuff. That's not bad. It's just a little less expensive. Really good, the fish field SS stuff here, the split rings and the solid rings, really high quality. Corkscrew swivels and so forth, that's really good stuff. And you guys look for three-way swivels. Let me see here, we got like regular three-way swivels, but oh, the P-Line is making these now. That's a three-way swivel with a bead chain built in. So I think they were kind of thinking side drifting when they put these together, but the bank guys, the plunkers, are buying a lot of these, and they do work well for that. So we've got a bunch more hooks coming, getting restocked on the hooks here from Gamagatsu. These Fishfield treble hooks, good quality, titanium coated. Those are really nice hooks. They're durable. They don't corrode. Really good stuff. Here's some these have a little extra wide gap, you know. I mean, those are great herring hooks right there, and so forth. And the P-Line squids, I will not go halibut or lingcod fishing without these. Those are really, really good. And you know, protect yourself from the sun. These fishaholic gloves, these are nice. I mean, don't let your hands end up looking like mine. Got the night lights back in, those things are great. And some clothing. You know, I got one pair of waders left. I was wearing these waders for probably 7 or 8 years, and I mean, they're really good. They didn't have any problems with them leaking. There's nothing. I had a zip-up kind. And finally, my zipper gave way after like 7 or 8 years. And I never really took care of them, right? You know, you want to store them zipped up, and I wanted to get that. But I've got one pair left, these Fishfield waders, size XL. Original price was $300, and I just have this on sale. I just can't get them right now. I don't know why, but there just aren't anymore. But if you want a good pair of waders, there you go. Get some Fishaholic sunglasses, but we sell a lot of these. That was full a week or two ago, so $20, good glasses. But if you're in the market for a higher end pair of sunglasses, I really suggest these Bahias. And we just got restocked on Washington coon shrimp. got a lot of bait. We'll have, we're sold out now, but fresh frozen coon shrimp, you know, if you want to cure your own. The way to do that, you know, they come in 35 pound boxes. If you want 35 pounds, that's fine. Just let us know and so we can order it for you special, because that's just the best way to do it. Or give us a call and say, oh, I want 10 pounds. And so we can separate out 10 pounds for you. Because that stuff's kind of hard to deal with, and you know, with freezer space and everything. But we'll be ordering once a week, you know, through the summer here. So if you want fresh coon shrimp, we got a good supply. And we got these Gerber knives, different styles here. Some of these tools and multi-tools. These are on the last one of these scissors here. But looking for a good fillet knife. $53, $48, $29, $48, different knives. You know, real good quality. And then also, I think, you know, P-line. So Don Newman's coming up pretty soon. We're gonna film on the Cowlitz River steelhead. But I think he mentioned he's got knives ready. They've been talking about doing fillet knives because we got, you know, the less expensive P-line fillet knives here. But I've got a knife going, I've had for probably 40 years now or so, 35 years maybe, that I drilled a hole in the end of it and put a spoon, you know, for cleaning the fish out. And I always wonder why, you know, you don't see those knives that much, or why companies don't do that. It, you know, it's not like I've never seen one like that around, but not very often. But I think P-Line's doing a knife like that. So it'll be a decent quality knife with a spoon built into it, which will be cool. So I'm excited to see those. So I've got lots of squids. There's lots of, got some, the boxes here ready to go, and some tools and the netting and the ghost thread. This is the best deal around. I don't know why anybody'd want anything else besides this. For $8, you get two big spools instead of paying $4 or whatever for a real small amount. You know, and you got the little container here that works really well. This ghost thread is good stuff. Powder coat, paint, the fishing boards, everything. So we're looking pretty good here. We got some more stuff coming and some things to work on, but I appreciate everybody coming in and, you know, supporting the local shops here, the small shops. And you know, a guy came in yesterday, bought two reels, and he said, you know, I really want to support the small business like this, and tell you what, that's what keeps the small businesses going, because it's just the way it is with the fishing industry. We really support appreciate, you know, your support. So please subscribe to the YouTube channel, and also join, I got a private Facebook group, Angler West Facebook group. There's like almost 4,000 members now. I think I created it like 3 weeks ago or so. So it's been growing pretty fast, and there's a really cool group of people in there. And if you have questions about something you've seen on the show, because a lot of people that you've seen on the show are members of the group, pretty much everybody, you can just message them directly. You can use that as a resource, you know, for talking to people specifically, you know, in you know, just a back and forth conversation. So that's kind of a cool thing about Facebook. But we've got that private group now. So I invite you to join in on that. Just do a search on Facebook for Angler West. And we'll hopefully be seeing you in the shop soon. Thanks.